Oh, I've been watching hockey since as long as I can remember, since I was, you know, a little wee guy. I've been watching hockey all through the 70s and 80s. I mean, that's all I did. You know, even before my parents deserted me, we used to watch hockey together. Yes, I did want to play in the NHL my whole life. And, you know, I thought if I ever was able to, you know, pay the registration to get into real minor hockey, I think I might have got, you know, I believe I might have went to the show. There's been a lot of people say I remind them of a young Wayne Gretzky. Many people have said that. I believe even Wayne Gretzky said that in an interview one time, if I'm not mistaken. I read somewhere Wayne Gretzky said, I saw Bubbles playing hockey and he's just like I used to be.
Here's the great Gretzky! Scores!
You know, around the 80s, I became a big Edmonton Oilers fan, you know, when they had the Dream Team there, and that was, you know, when we would have the road hockey games, everybody would call out what team they had. Me and Ricky and Julian would always call out the Oilers. And of course, I was 99. You know, I'd be Gretzky. Julian was like he was sort of, you know, he's a bigger guy, right? So he would always call, like, you know, Dave Semenko or somebody like that. I think probably because Semenko was the guy that looked the most like Patrick Swayze, and Julian really, really likes Patrick Swayze. Ricky fancied himself a bit of a Glenn Anderson type, bit of a playmaker, you know, because he'd get really high and he thought he could see into the future and stuff. Oh, we play hockey, you know, in the summer at least three times a week. A game breaks out, and then in the winter, I mean, Ricky and Julian are usually in jail in the winter, so, you know, I go for skates and things like that, and sometimes just bring Corey and Trevor out just to, you know, punish them into the boards and stuff. But I'll try to get on the ice, you know, two, three times a week. Oh yeah, that's my hockey helmet from when I was a kid. That's the old Cooper Crash. The old Cooper Crash helmet from the 70s. I think it was the 3000, I think was the number on it. But I've taken a lot of serious jolts to the head with that thing on. So it's a good helmet. Me and two line mates. I'd have to put Wayne on there. I think I'd put Wayne and LaFleur out there with me. I think those two could, you know, really keep up with me, maybe put Coffey on defense, for sure. That'd be a good line. No, there was a pond in Sunnyvale, and we used to have an actual rink in Sunnyvale. It burned down since then, but it used to be a nice rink, and, you know, the old wooden boards and the mesh screen. We never had the glass, but it was a nice rink. Leahy used to be the rink supervisor, actually, back then. He used to take care of the rink, and you drove the tractor and everything. We didn't have a Zamboni or anything, but we had an old farm tractor with a big ice scraper on the back, and Leahy'd get out there and clean the ice until he got fired. He got drunk one time. Well, most of the time he was driving the tractor cleaning the ice, he'd be wasted, and one time the gas stuck and it got out of control, and he was going through the boards and right through the canteen, flung him off the tractor, pissed himself. It was horrible. Big yellow piss stain on the ice. It stayed there for about close to 2 years. Nobody wanted to skate over the piss stain. I've been to a few NHL games live. Went to a Rangers game. Sean Avery, I know that guy. He fired a puck at me. I was up, just got to my seat with a hot dog and a popcorn and a thing, and Avery fired a puck right off my jaw just to be an arsehole.
Did he apologize? Did he?
No, he thought it was very cute. He thought it was very cute that he rifled one off my chin. Favorite tough guys. Jeez, I don't know. I mean, I used to like Terry O'Reilly.
O'Reilly has been hitting everything in sight.
Terry O'Reilly was a mean bastard back in the 70s. I liked him a lot. I liked Semenko a lot. McSorley, liked McSorley. Ty Domi, obviously. I fought Ty Domi one time at a bar, you know, and he's a lot tougher than you think. I suckered him. Everything I had, I cranked him, and he just sort of blinked, and he was like, who are you? And then he beat me almost to death. So don't ever fight Ty Domi at a bar, I'll tell you right now.
You can complain if you want to complain.
It was a big thrill to meet Don Cherry. And in the video there, you know, we're sort of fighting, and I thought I was gonna just sort of manhandle him, but he's pretty strong. He's a pretty muscular dude, I didn't realize. I thought I was just going to be flopping him around like nothing. And he took it pretty serious. He, you know, he grabbed onto me. I couldn't move him. A couple of those outtakes didn't make it into the video. He gave me a couple good shots in the mouth, you know, just to let me know who was boss or whatever.
Here's Crosby with a burst of speed. Up the middle, gets up and scores! Welcome back, Sid!
Oh, I think Sidney Crosby's fantastic. And, like, little-known fact, you know, he's from the East Coast, people know that, but a lot of people don't know that I used to coach him. I taught him a lot of the stuff he knows, all those fancy tricks through the feet and stuff. That was me. I taught Sid all that stuff. No, I haven't talked to him. I mean, he's pretending like he doesn't know me, even though I, you know, basically taught him everything he knows. He's won't return my calls. Hockey's a huge, huge, huge thing on the East Coast of Canada. I mean, I think, you know, eventually it'd be nice if we could get our own team out there, NHL team, because people would come from, you know, they would drive hundreds of miles just to see the games. So I think it would fly. I'm going to start working on that, maybe put in a bid.